Four bullets in the back, and the Russian opposition leader's voice was silenced. Even as authorities promise an investigation, many believe Boris Nemtsov never stood a chance.
The opposition is excluded and delegitimized. There's no room for even constructive criticism in the Russian political system.
The killing has revived memories of other cases. The journalist Anna Politkovskaya, a vocal critic of Russia's war in Chechnya, her home was a safe place until it became the scene of her murder. Shot four times in the entrance of her Moscow apartment in 2006. And Alexander Litvinenko, a former KGB officer, died a slow death after drinking a lethal dose of radioactive polonium. His tea spiked in a London hotel during a meeting with two former Russian security servicemen. All fierce and outspoken critics of President Vladimir Putin, all killed in mysterious ways.
We still don't know who ordered those killings, and now we have this one. What do you think those deaths have in common?
Well, I don't think they have anything in common.
The Kremlin has denied any involvement in the cases, and a former Kremlin advisor believes President Putin is innocent.
There's absolutely no proof of any involvement of the Russian state.
But those suspicious deaths are not the only ones. A 50-year-old human rights activist was dumped by the side of a road with bullet wounds to her head. A trainee journalist and a human rights lawyer both shot in broad daylight, meters from the Kremlin. The editor of Forbes Russia killed with a machine gun outside his Moscow office. And a business tycoon in self-exile was found with a noose around his neck. Was it a suicide? The coroner could not say. The Kremlin promised a thorough investigation each time. Some of those cases have led to convictions. The latest assassination of Boris Nemtsov has sparked a flood of conspiracy theories from politicians and investigators, from claims it was extremists or perhaps people within his own party attempting to destabilize the government. Russian President Putin has vowed to track down the killer or killers.
People like him are always under surveillance in Russia. So, I mean, in this sense, he had bodyguards, but they were from Russian state agents. There is no way he wasn't under the state surveillance. And moreover, there were the surveillance cameras all over the place.
Despite a financial reward, so far no one has come forward. Lynda Kinkade, CNN.